Hello, my dear students. Welcome to CMI's online classes. In today's class, for the students of Standard 7, we will continue with Chapter 6 of our English grammar, that is adjectives. And in this video, we will understand the degrees of comparison of adjectives. Degrees of comparison of adjectives. Here we have to understand the word comparison. So here, whenever we compare a noun with another noun or a pronoun with another pronoun, we use adjectives to bring their comparison. Understood? Because adjectives show the qualities of nouns and pronouns. And we compare a noun or a pronoun with another noun or a pronoun by showing their qualities. We also compare a noun or a pronoun with another noun or a pronoun by showing their work. When we compare them by showing their work, there we use adverbs, and it is called the degrees of comparison of adverbs that we are going to understand in our later chapter. Okay, so but here we are going to understand the degrees of comparison of adjectives. Adjectives, as we have already understood in our previous video, with their definitions and examples. And we have already understood that adjectives bring out the qualities of nouns or pronouns. Okay. And now when we compare these nouns or pronouns with other nouns and pronouns, we use these adjectives because these adjectives show qualities of nouns and pronouns. And whenever we bring comparison of nouns and pronouns, we use adjectives because we use qualities to bring their comparison. Okay. So, there are three degrees of comparison of adjectives. They are positive degree, one number. Next is comparative degree. And the last one is superlative degree. Now, in this video, we are going to understand what is positive degree, what is comparative degree, and what is superlative degree, and how the comparison of nouns and pronouns are brought in these three degrees. That means, in what sense positive degree is used to show the comparison of nouns and pronouns. Okay, in the same way, in what way this comparative degree of adjectives are used to bring comparison. Okay, in the same way, in the same manner, how is superlative degree of comparison is used to compare what kind of nouns. Okay, in what situation do we use comparative degree, superlative degrees of adjectives, and how these three degrees of adjectives are formed, that we will understand with the structure of each adjective word here in this video. Okay, students, so I want you all to listen to the explanation while watching the video, because to understand how comparative degree is framed from positive degree and how superlative degree is framed from comparative degree, that needs a lot of attention. So you need to understand with full attention. I hope you all will listen to the explanation very attentively so that you will all come to know about the structure of sentences, structure of adjective words, how they are changed from positive to comparative and comparative to superlative degree. Okay, students. So the first degree of comparison of adjective is positive degree of adjective, or positive degree of comparison of adjectives. So what do you mean by positive degree of adjectives? Positive degree of adjectives ka matlab kya hota hai? So we all know that adjectives are the words that qualify or describe nouns and pronouns by showing their qualities, quantities, numbers, shapes and sizes, etc. So here, how to identify the used noun, the used adjective is in positive form. Okay, so let us understand with its definition. An adjective is said to be in the positive form. हम उस समय एडजेक्टिव को पॉजिटिव फॉर्म मानेंगे जिस समय इफ इट इज यूज्ड मियरली टू डिस्क्राइब अ नाउन और अ प्रोनाउन. इफ दैट नाउन इफ दैट एडजेक्टिव इज यूज्ड टू जस्ट डिस्क्राइब अ नाउन और प्रोनाउन, अगर वो एडजेक्टिव सिर्फ विदाउट शोइंग एनी कंपेरिजन, इफ दैट एडजेक्टिव इज यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब और क्वालिफाई अ नाउन और अ प्रोनाउन, देन दैट एडजेक्टिव इज पॉजिटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव. ओके, मोस्टली इट डज नॉट ब्रिंग कंपेरिजन. सो वेन एवर वी यूज पॉजिटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव वी डू नॉट शो कंपेरिजन. ओके, मोस्टली. बट इट डज नॉट मीन दैट बाई यूजिंग पॉजिटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव वी डोंट ब्रिंग कंपेरिजन. Sometimes it brings comparison also, but we have to understand how. If it brings a comparison, agar, if we use positive degree of adjectives to show the comparison, what happens at that time? The qualities shown are similar to another nouns or pronouns with which the nouns are compared. To us samay, जिस समय हम पॉजिटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव यूज करके कंपैरिजन दिखाने की कोशिश करते हैं, तो उस समय जिस क्वालिटीज को हम दिखाते हैं उस क्वालिटी को हम इक्वल दिखाते हैं. वी शो इक्वल इन द क्वालिटीज यूजिंग विच वी आर शोइंग कंपैरिजन. लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल्स, राम इज अ टॉल बॉय. सो राम इज अ बॉय. सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बॉय ही इज? Tall boy. So tall is an adjective. Okay, so here tall is just used to compare, to describe the noun. Here we are not showing any comparison. So this is positive degree of adjective. This is adjective and which degree? Positive. And another one is Sita is a good girl. Sita is a girl. What kind of girl? Good. So here we are not showing comparison of Sita with anyone. Okay, so here good is positive adjective. Okay, now see, Ram is as tall as Sam. Here we are bringing comparison between Ram and Sam. We are comparing two nouns, but if you see, the quality here is tall. We are talking about which quality of being tall. So here, however the Ram is tall, the same height is of Sam. So this quality, they are equal in this quality. Okay, like Sita is as good as Rita. So we are comparing Sita with Rita, but the quality of being good is same, similar. Understood? So whenever we show a comparison by using positive degree, we use the word as before and after the adjective. Understood? So this is also an example of simile. Showing comparison, okay, direct comparison by showing qualities, that quality is adjective. Understood, students? Are you clear about positive degree of adjectives? I hope you are. But if still you have doubt, so you may ask me during the class period. Now, another degree of comparison of adjectives, that is comparative degree of adjectives. So, what is comparative degree of adjectives? So let us understand. An adjective is said to be in the comparative form. So adjective ko hum tab comparative form mein mante hai when, if it is used to show the comparison between two nouns or two groups of nouns. Jab hum kisi ek noun ko ya ek group of nouns ko dusre noun ke saath ya dusre group of nouns ke saath compare karte hai, to us samay hum jis adjective ka istemal karte hai, that adjective is comparative adjective. Understood? Usually the comparative degree of adjectives are followed by the word than. So whenever we use comparative degrees of adjectives, जब भी हम comparative degree of adjective का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, तो उस समय हमेशा से ज्यादातर उस adjective के बाद than, word than का use होता है. Understood? Let us see in examples. For examples, Rohan is taller than Karan. So we are comparing Rohan with Karan. So there is difference in this quality of being tall. So tall, I have used here taller. So taller is the adjective here, and it brings the comparison between two nouns, Rohan and Karan. So this comparative degree of adjectives, it shows the differences in qualities by using which we show the comparison of nouns. Understood? Like here, see, they have difference in height. Understood? Rohan is taller than Karan in their height. Like Karim is better in mathematics than Wasim. So we are comparing Karim with Wasim. So what difference? They have difference of being good in mathematics. That is better. Okay. Better is the adjective here. So we have used better to bring comparison between Karim and Wasim. By using better, we saw the differences in their quality. So this is comparative degree of adjectives. Understood? So the comparative degree of adjectives bring comparison between two nouns or two groups of nouns, and they bring difference in their qualities whenever we show their comparison. Now the last degree of comparison of adjectives, that is superlative degree of adjectives. So what is superlative degree of adjectives? Let us understand. An adjective is said to be in the superlative form. Hum adjective ko superlative adjective, wo adjective superlative form mein hai, us samay mante hai, kab? When it is used to compare with the rest of the nouns of their kinds, or the group of nouns is compared with all other groups of nouns of their kinds. जब एक नाउन को हम उसके जैसा बाकी सारे नाउन्स के साथ कंपेयर करते हैं, और किसी ग्रुप ऑफ नाउन्स को बाकी ग्रुप्स ऑफ नाउन्स उसके जैसा बाकी ग्रुप ऑफ नाउन्स के साथ कंपेयर करते हैं, तो उस समय हम जिस एडजेक्टिव का इस्तेमाल करते हैं वो सुपरलेटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स होते हैं. ओके, एंड वॉट इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, यूजुअली द सुपरलेटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स आर प्रीसीडेड बाय द डेफिनेट आर्टिकल द. सो whenever we use the superlative degree of adjectives, before using superlative degree of adjectives, we use the definite article the. Understood? This has to be understood whenever we are studying articles also. Article the is used before the superlative form of adjectives. Understood? Like for examples, Arun is the tallest boy in his class. So here Arun is being compared with the other boys of his class. Okay, and among all other boys, Arun is the tallest. Okay, Arun is the tallest boy. So here Rahul is the best batsman of our team. So we have so many batsmen. We have many batsmen in our team, but among all of them, Rahul is the best. So best is the superlative degree of adjective, and we see that definite article the is used here. As in case of comparative degree of adjectives also, I had told you that the word than is used after adjective. So this is adjective, so than is used after the adjective. Okay, here better is adjective, so here than has come after the adjective we have used. Understood, students? Now we will understand how to change positive degree of adjectives into comparative degree and superlative degree with their word structures. Okay, so before that we have to understand that again there are two types of degrees of comparison of adjectives. One is regular degrees of comparison of adjectives. First we will see this regular degrees of comparison of adjectives. Understood? So to understand how to frame the structure of the degrees of adjectives, at first we have to understand syllable, word syllable. Okay, syllable means unit of words. See, whenever we divide the words into their parts depending upon the pronunciation. Okay, जब हम किसी भी शब्द को उच्चारण करके उसको डिवाइड करते हैं कि कितने बारे में हम उसे कंप्लीट कर पाते हैं, सो ईच पार्ट को हम सिलेबल कहेंगे, सिलेबल कहते हैं. सो व्हाट सिलेबल, एट फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट सिलेबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डिग्रीज ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स. सो हियर पॉजिटिव डिग्री, सो आई हैव रिटन हियर लॉन्ग. लॉन्ग इज द पॉजिटिव डिग्री ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स एंड इट हैज ओनली वन सिलेबल, वन सिलेबल, बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट डिवाइड दिस वर्ड विथ प्रोनाउंसिएशन. इट कैन बी प्रोनाउंस्ड एट वंस. सो लॉन्ग को हम एक ही बार में प्रोनाउंस कर पाते हैं, तो इसे हम सिंगल सिलेबिक वर्ड कहते हैं. ओके, सिंगल सिलेबिक एडजेक्टिव और सिंगल सिलेबिक वर्ड, अंडरस्टूड. नाउ अगर एडजेक्टिव सिंगल सिलेबल का हो तो हम उसमें सिर्फ कंपेरेटिव डिग्री में उसके बाद ईआर ऐड करेंगे, लाइक लॉन्गर, लॉन्ग लॉन्गर ईआर ऐड करेंगे तो पॉजिटिव कंपेरेटिव डिग्री हुआ. अगर ईएसटी ऐड करते हैं तो सुपरलेटिव डिग्री होता है, लॉन्ग लॉन्गर लॉन्गेस्ट. कंपेरेटिव डिग्री ईआर, सुपरलेटिव डिग्री ईएसटी. ओके, सो लाइक short, shorter, shortest. Okay, now see, this is wise. Wise is also single syllabic word. Okay, because we can pronounce it at once, wise. But if you see, it has ended with e. Okay, if any single syllabic word or adjectives end with e, then we just have to add r only, because e is already here. No need to add e again. So er, wiser, wisest. In comparative degree, just add R, and in superlative degree, T. ST. Understood? Because E is already here. Understood? That means wise, positive degree, wiser, comparative degree, and wisest, superlative degree. Now, hot. Another important information to understand here about the formation of degrees of adjectives. This is hot. Hot is also a single syllabic word, but it ends with consonant and it has a vowel before it. If any single syllabic word ends with single consonant and has single vowel before it, in that case we have to double the consonant, double that consonant, and after that we have to add er, like hot, hot. So here in case of comparative degree, we have to double this consonant T, hotter, and in superlative degree also double consonant and EST. Understood? I hope you are clear. Like sad, sadder, saddest, fit, fitter, fittest. Okay, double consonant. Understood? Now see example number 4. Easy, healthy. Number 5. Number 6, handsome. See, easy, double syllabic word, two syllable, words of two syllables. So we also call them disyllabic words. Disyllabic words. If adjectives are disyllabic and ends with y, agar koi bhi adjectives double syllable wala ho aur wo y se end hota ho, so to change it into comparative degree, we have to remove y, and in place of y we will put I and again er. Okay, like easy, in case of comparative degree we have to omit, we have to remove y, and we have to add ier. Okay, easy, easier, easiest. In case of superlative degree, remove y and add iest. Like healthy, two syllable word, healthy, two syllables. Again, healthier, healthiest. Remove I and add IER. Remove Y and add IER. Remove Y in superlative degree and add IEST. Understood? But in case of double syllabic adjectives, if the adjectives which are double syllabic, if they do not end with Y, then we have to add more plus adjective and most plus adjective. More plus adjective in comparative degree and most plus adjective in superlative degree. Like handsome, two syllabic word. In case of comparative degree, more handsome, more plus adjective handsome. Okay, and most handsome. most plus adjective in comparative degree. Now, if the adjectives are of more than two syllable, three syllable adjectives, four syllabic words, they are called trisyllabics. Okay, so अगर कोई भी adjectives trisyllabic हो और उससे ज्यादा syllable वाला word हो तो उसमें हम फिर से more plus the same adjective and most plus the same adjective, like intelligent, more intelligent, more plus same adjective intelligent, and in superlative degree most plus intelligent, most plus same adjective intelligent, natural, more natural, most natural. Understood, students? I hope you have understood the formation of degrees of comparison of adjectives. Now we have to understand another degrees of adjective, that is irregular degrees of adjectives. So irregular degrees of adjectives are those adjectives which have different form in comparative and superlative degrees. They've changed themselves into new words. Okay, unlike regular degrees of adjectives. Understood? Like in regular degrees of adjectives, we have same adjective words there. In positive degree also we have same, in comparative degree also we have same, in superlative degree also we have same. Like intelligent, in positive degree, more intelligent. So intelligent, same adjective is there, adjective is there also in comparative degree. In superlative degree, most intelligent. So same adjective is there. Okay, so we will make little bit changes by adding some words, by changing the structure of sentences, structure of adjective words to change into comparative and superlative in regular degrees of adjectives. But in irregular degrees of adjectives, we frame new words in each new word in each degree, like positive degree. तो ये जो irregular degrees of adjective है ये हमें याद करना है. Okay, because it does not follow the grammatical structure as we have learnt in regular degrees of adjective. Okay, so here good is positive degree, so comparative degree is better and superlative degree is best. Bad, positive degree, worse. Comparative degree, worst. Superlative degree, little. Positive degree, less. Comparative degree, least. Superlative degree, many or much. Dono, both of them are positive degree, and whenever both of them are changed in comparative degree, more we have to use, and when they are changed into superlative degree, most we have to use. Okay, now we are left with upward degree of adjectives and downward degree of adjectives that we will understand in class itself. Okay, students, so I hope you have understood the degrees of comparison of adjectives, and now you are able to form or frame the degrees of adjectives. You are able to change the degrees of adjectives from positive to comparative, and comparative to superlative. So if still you have any doubts regarding the degrees of adjectives, then kindly raise your doubts during the class period. So this much for today's class. Thank you so much, students, for attending today's class. Thank you so much.